What's Gone Wrong with German Education? Our guest this week on the interview is Annette Schavan, German Minister for Education and Research.
Ms. Schavan, everyone in Germany is talking about it. Do we have an education crisis in this country?
Crisis is an exaggeration. We are working to improve quality, have more social mobility, and finally, to ensure that every child and every young person achieves good qualifications that enable them to access further training or university.
But if you look at Germany from outside, this is an extremely successful country with an unbelievably successful industrial sector with many, many thousands of patents every year. The education system in this country can't really be that bad.
That's true. Germany would not be so successful economically, but also with regard to cultural and social developments in our country, if we did not have a very versatile educational system. I believe that is the real strength. There is not just one way to enter professional education. There are different ways, some of them very good. So, when we're working on weak points, it's not necessary to talk everything down.
Let's take the dual system of vocational training. Anyone who's lived abroad dreams of having a German plumber at home. They'd be given jobs in England, France, or Belgium. Do we really need to learn and adopt that kind of thing from abroad? Do we have to look to Finland?
No. Wherever I am in the world, I'm asked about the dual training system. I'm asked whether Germany can't perhaps help set up this system in other places. This really good cooperation between the company on the one hand, the school on the other. The dual system is the best prevention against youth unemployment, and it also guarantees a supply of really good skilled workers for the companies. We need more self-confidence about our educational system.
And that's why one sometimes asks, is the talk of education crisis, education catastrophe an issue? Educational policy seems to be a permanent political work in progress. Is that not actually a mistake?
Educational policy develops in proportion to how society develops. Compared to whatever other policy area over the last 50 years, I can see major changes. It's right that German society doesn't want continuous structural debate. It doesn't want a situation where, as soon as one government or one state government is elected, they say, now we're going to change absolutely everything again. But I do think having an efficient education system has always involved asking the question, what should children learn? And I think we have to ask that more often. What is the content? The goals? So fewer technocratic debates, fewer debates about structures, organization, and more debate about the substance of the educational system. And that means the educational content, the goals of learning and education.
What do you understand under education?
I'm fairly classically formed. I'm a social scientist myself, and, put most succinctly, education for me is the interaction of content and the development of competence, leading to powers of reasoning, independence, and character formation. Wilhelm von Humboldt perhaps formulated it a bit idealistically, but in the final analysis, he's right. It's about the whole person, their independence, their ability to reason, their opportunity to develop their talents. Not just an accumulation of knowledge,
but also accumulation of knowledge.
Without knowledge, it's all a bit difficult, so that can't be neglected. Also, practice. That's sometimes seen as old-fashioned. But memorizing texts, practicing certain skills that I've acquired so that I can gain a certain amount of confidence, I think that has a place in school routine.
In Germany, education policy is a bit more complicated than in other countries, for example, France. We have federalism. The federal states have had an exclusive say over education for a few years now. In your view, is that still sensible in a globalized world, in a global competition for the best minds?
Most European countries have federalism. That's not distracting, not even in a global world. But the federalism has to modernize. Society rightfully wants to be able to compare what has been learned, to be able to compare educational qualifications. Families want to be mobile, and that's part of the debate in Germany. Is it right to always dismiss the issue with the sentence, that's the federal state's business? Or is it not time for us to talk to each other more about what is important for all 16 states, so that more mobility is possible? So that people with school-aged children who move from one federal state to another do not experience a disaster.
Sie waren jahrelang Kultusministerin in Baden-Württemberg, Bayern, Baden-Württemberg und seit 20 Jahren auch Sachsen zählen immer zu den Spitzenreitern im deutschen Bildungssystem. Und trotzdem wird immer darüber gestritten, jeder, die anderen suchen andere Wege. Wäre es nicht eigentlich vernünftiger, einfach von den dreien zu lernen?
Das ist wohl wahr.
The most important lesson is that both the southern states, Bavaria and Baden-Württemberg, have continuously developed their educational policies for more than 50 years. The continuity is in the forefront. That also allows for admitting new responsibilities. And, of course, developing different educational profiles is part of that, but not always tinkering around with structures. That's the recipe for success.
Is the education debate in Germany too ideologically burdened?
For a long time it was ideological. Sometimes it seems like each government sees it as a defining trophy issue. That's positive, because it makes clear that educational policy is something important. No other issue is so emotionally charged. Almost every family is affected. Everyone knows someone who goes to school. I've always valued that vigorous discussion a lot, but we mustn't lose sight of what is pedagogically correct. And there are many questions in educational policy that must be decided on a pedagogical level. They can't be decided politically.
Education policy is certainly a defining issue of the century, not just for Germans. It's about securing prosperity, safeguarding a way of life, too. This has been your area of responsibility for years. Do you have the impression that society as a whole is now more aware of how unbelievably important education policy is?
Yes, a lot has changed. Many people now talk about the educational republic of Germany. That's a good image for what we want. And since the first PISA study in 2001, a lot has changed objectively. We have many good initiatives to strengthen early childhood education. We have understood that education begins not in school, but in the family. Family education and guidance plays a big role. We are addressing the issue of people leaving school early. The rates are falling steadily. A lot is much more positive. And that's why Germany is also the country with the lowest youth unemployment in international comparison. That doesn't mean that there are no unsolved issues, but it has improved significantly, and we are slowly succeeding in awakening society's enthusiasm for the possibilities inherent in the education system.
Ms. Chavan, thank you very much.
You're welcome.